Hello friends, my name is Panindra. In this video, let us learn about denaturation and renaturation. So what is meant by denaturation? When DNA gets heated and hydrogen bonds between the base pairs become weak and finally breaks. So what do you understand by this? Normally we know the double stranded DNA. So firstly you have to understand the diagram. This is the double stranded DNA, and what is meant by double stranded DNA? It mainly consists of two strands. This is one of the strand and this is another strand. So look there, I have named it as AB, and so A is one of the strand and B is another strand. So between each of the strand there is a formation of hydrogen bonds between them. The hydrogen bonds is mainly present between nitrogenous base pairs. So see here, separation of base pairs. When DNA gets heated and hydrogen bonds between the base pairs become weak and finally breaks, so separation of base pairs takes place. So here there is a presence of base pairs. If you see in this diagram, there is a base pair. So what is mean by base pairs? Base pairs are nothing but nitrogenous base pairs. It consists of both purines and pyrimidines. Purines includes adenine and guanine, whereas pyrimidines include cytosine, thymine and uracil. And adenine is denoted by A, guanine is denoted by G, cytosine is denoted by C, thymine is denoted by T, and uracil is denoted by U. So these are the base pairs which are mainly present between both of the strands. See, this is the zoom diagram of this denaturation. If you consider, this is first strand and this is second strand A B. Between two of the strands there is a presence of nitrogenous base pairs. That is nothing but nucleotides. Both are same as C G A T G C. What is C? C means cytosine, G means guanine. There is a presence of hydrogen bond which I have drawn with the blue pen. And A adenine, T presence of hydrogen bond between them, and C and G and C, there is a presence of hydrogen bond between these both nucleotide base pairs. These are known as base pairs. So what happens, what they are given in the definition? Separation of base pairs, that is nothing but DNA when it gets heated. So this is the DNA. When this DNA undergoes heating, then when it undergoes heating, what happens? The hydrogen bonds between the base pairs. So these are the base pairs, C, A, G, G, T, C. These are the hydrogen bonds. The hydrogen bonds present between the base pairs become weak and finally break. Breaking takes place. See here, I have drawn you here. Breaking takes place between each of the nucleotide base pairs. So when this breaking takes place, then what happens? See here, finally the both of the strands gets break along with the hydrogen bonds. So what happens, both of the nitrogenous base pairs, nothing but CAG and GTC will go the underneath and this underneath. So what happens, finally the both of the strands get separated in the diagrammatic. See here, A strand and B strand. When these both strands gets undergoes heating, when DNA, double stranded DNA undergoes heating, then what happens? The hydrogen bonds which are mainly present between the nucleotide base pairs will get breaking, and first it becomes weak and then it gets break. So what happens? Breaking takes place and mainly forms two single stranded DNA. So this is A strand and this is B strand, and it also consists of its appropriate nucleotides. For example, say here, I have drawn you here CAG. This CAG belongs to its A strand. CAG, this is A strand and this is B strand. That is A strand and this is B strand. So this A strand mainly consists of CAG, that is nothing but cytosine, adenine and guanine nucleotides. Whereas B strand mainly consists of guanine, thymine and cytosine. And this nucleotides belongs to this strand, A B strand, and this nucleotides, these three nucleotides belongs to A strand. So A strand consists of these all nucleotides, cytosine, adenine and guanine. Not only these three will get repeated. Cytosine, adenine, guanine, cytosine, adenine, guanine, cytosine, adenine, guanine, like that. In the same way, this B strand also consists of these nucleotides, appropriate nucleotides of which it contains. GTC, that is nothing but guanine, tyrosine, cytosine, guanine, tyrosine, cytosine and guanine, tyrosine, cytosine. So these are the nucleotide base pairs along with the single stranded DNA present with the appropriate, that is nothing but A and B. So this is about the denaturation. Now let us know what are the factors which affects denaturation. The main factor which affects denaturation is temperature. To know the temperature, first you have to know what is meant by melting temperature. So the temperature at which 50% of DNA gets denatured is called melting temperature. So 50% of DNA gets denatured. For example, if you see here, double stranded DNA, here the denaturation takes place, but only 50% takes place, not totally, only 50% of denaturation takes place, and that phenomenon is known as melting temperature. And the temperature, the point of temperature which is used in the denaturation is 260 nanometers. Melting temperature is denoted by TM. and 260 nanometers. The temperature which is mainly utilized for the half of the denaturation is known as 260 nanometers. In this melting temperature, half of the double stranded DNA leads to formation, and another half single stranded DNA leads to formation. So both of these double stranded DNA and single stranded DNA consists only of 0.5%, but not totally, because 50% of DNA gets denatured. That's it. So next, this is an important point. When two strands of DNA get together, proximity arises between them, between both of the nucleated base pairs, and decreases the absorbent, and this phenomenon is known as quenching. So what do you understand by this? When two strands of DNA, I have set you here A strand and B strand, when both of the strands gets together, then proximity arises between each of the base pairs. When this both gets denatured, comes together, when this adenine and for example, if you take this nucleated base pair, adenine and tyrosine, if these both nucleotides comes together, then the proximity arises between them. Proximity means nothing but tension arises between them. So due to the tension, what happens? Finally, the breaking of bonds takes place. So finally, denaturation, that is nothing but separation of double stranded DNA into the single stranded DNA, leads to take place. And that phenomenon is known as quenching. This quenching will be asked in MSc entrance examinations. So what they ask is, they will give this question and they will give the options like quenching, hyperchromacity. They will try to confuse you. So what you have to write is, it is quenching. So what is quenching? When two strands of DNA gets together, that is nothing but two strands of DNA is nothing but the A strand consists of its appropriate nucleotide CAG, whereas B strand consists of its appropriate nucleotide GTC. And this nucleotides of the strand and this nucleotides of the strand gets together, then the proximity arises between them, and the hydrogen bond which is mainly present between the both of the base pairs gets breakdown, and finally it mainly leads to the formation of denaturation. That is nothing but finally it mainly forms two single stranded DNA, and this phenomenon is known as quenching. Next, hyperchromacity. What is hyperchromacity? It is also one of the important question answer which will be asked in degree examinations. So increase with 30-40% rise in absorbent value can be noted. This increase in absorbent value can be shown by the denatured DNA is known as hyperchromacity. So what do you understand by this? 30-40% in increase of denaturation, absorbent value will increase in the denaturation. So if the denaturation process takes place, then the absorbent value will increase up to 30-40%, only up to 30-40%, and then up to the 34-40%, then it is said to be as hyperchromacity. When it leads to more or else less, up to 10-20%, then it is said to be as hypochromacity. Hyper and hypo, hyper means up to 30-40, whereas hypo means 10-20. So what is hyperchromacity? Increase in the absorbent value with 30-40% during denaturation is known as hyperchromacity. And this is the graph of melting temperature. See, x-axis consists of temperature and y-axis consists of absorbent value, which is nothing but 260 nanometers, that is nothing but TM value. And this is the TM curve which will be obtained if you take the values while doing the experiments in the laboratory. Then you will get the values, then with the appropriate values you have to plot the graph, and the scale you have to take with 10 20 30, or else here 0.5 0.05 0.10 0.15. It depends upon the value of which you get during the experiment in the laboratory. Next, what is mean by Chargaff's rule? Simply to say Chargaff's rule, A plus G by T plus C is equals to 1. This is Chargaff's rule. So to explain deeply about the Chargaff's rule, what you have to know is, ratio of purines and pyrimidines is equals to 1. In before, what I have said you, what are purines and pyrimidines? Purines consists of adenine and guanine, whereas pyrimidines consists of cytosine, thymine and uracil. See here. Purines consists of adenine and guanine, pyrimidines consists of cytosine, thymine and uracil. Yeah, see here. Purines, adenine and guanine, pyrimidines, cytosine, thymine, uracil, which is denoted by AGCTU. Adenine, A plus G, ratio of purines and pyrimidines. So upper takes place with purines and lower takes place with pyrimidines. Purines, pyrimidines. Ratio of purines and pyrimidines is equals to 1. Adenine and guanine are belongs to purines, whereas tyrosine, thymine, cytosine, thymine, uracil, cytosine, uracil, all of this belongs to pyrimidines. So the ratio of purines and pyrimidines is equals to 1. This is known as Chargaff's rule. And the amount of heat required for the denaturation depends upon its nucleotide composition. So what do you understand by this? The heat, normally I have said you that denaturation takes place when there is a heat. When the DNA gets heated, then the hydrogen bonds which are mainly present between the nitrogenous base pairs becomes weak and finally breaks. I have said you the definition of the denaturation, right? So the amount of heat required. So for the process of denaturation, to occur the process of denaturation, heat is required. So the amount of heat required for denaturation depends upon its nucleotide composition. So for example, if this is a nucleotide composition, if there is a bonds which are mainly present between the both nucleotides, consists of three hydrogen bonds between the nucleotides, then what happens? Then the breaking of hydrogen bond between takes place between both of the nucleotide base pairs. If it consists of three hydrogen bonds between guanine and cytosine, then what happens? G, triple bond C, it takes high amount of melting temperature. But if it consists of only one hydrogen bond, then it takes low amount of TM value, that is nothing but temperature. For example, if you take mammalian DNA consists of GC content with two hydrogen bonds, so it requires medium amount of heat to get denatured in that way. So this is about denaturation. Now let us go to renaturation. Renaturation is very simple, it is quietly opposite to the denaturation. That is nothing but in denaturation what happens? See here, in denaturation what happens, the double stranded DNA will get converted into the single strand DNA by the breaking of hydrogen bonds which are mainly present between the nucleotide base pairs, and this is known as denaturation. Whereas in renaturation, single stranded DNA will get converted into double stranded DNA. Whereas in denaturation what happens, double stranded DNA gets converted into single stranded DNA. Whereas in renaturation what happens, single stranded DNA will get converted into double stranded DNA. So here nitrogenous bases also gets occurred. So here it loses nitrogenous bases, that is appropriate nitrogenous bases are present in each strand. A, this is A strand and this is B strand. I have said you in denaturation, this A strand consists of appropriate nucleotides of CAG, that is nothing but cytosine, adenine, guanine, cytosine, adenine, guanine, and here also cytosine, adenine and guanine. Whereas in B strand, this is B strand, it consists of GTC, that is nothing but guanine, thymine, cytosine, guanine, thymine, cytosine, and here also guanine, thymine, cytosine. So here what happens is, here renaturation takes place. How the renaturation takes place? Normally denaturation it requires heat, but in renaturation it requires cooling. Due to that cooling, both of these strands will get together, will combine together and mainly forms double stranded DNA. When it combines together, then the nucleotides also will get combined by hydrogen bonds. The hydrogen linkage takes place between them. For example, if you see GC and AT and CG, I have drawn you here, right? Here, this is renaturation. Renaturation process takes place quietly opposite. See here, this nucleotides belongs to A strand and this nucleotides belongs to B strand. So during cooling, this occurs in heating and this occurs in cooling. So during cooling, what happens? The formation of hydrogen bonds takes place. Why the formation of hydrogen bond takes place? For attaching the both of the strands, both A strand and B strand, to form double stranded DNA. And this is known as renaturation. So finally let us come to the definition. The single stranded DNA undergoes cooling and will form double stranded DNA along with the nucleotide composition. This is known as renaturation. If you like this video, please do like and subscribe, and if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment in the comment box. I will clarify your doubts. Thank you.